Well, good morning, everyone. It is a tremendous pleasure to be here with you this morning. As Rajul has mentioned, I am an alumna. And in addition to having a policy seminar for you this morning, we're also celebrating the development of a new IMI office here in Washington, kindly hosted for us here at IFPRI. So this is the first time that we are delighted to have a formal IMI office in Washington. We hope that this can make us a better engaged, more responsive partner with all of you and help us to engage more completely and more timely in the global discussions that are so necessary in water these days. Let me begin by saying I think many of us are aware that right now in New York, the high-level political forum is ongoing. And this is the annual review of the progress toward the SDGs. And each year, when the political forum is ongoing, they choose a number of SDGs to look at. And this year, they're looking at the water SDG. And this is sort of a good news, bad news story. The MDGs, which were reasonably well attained in water, focused only on access to water. The SDGs are far more ambitious. The SDGs are looking at the management of water, the quality of water, the reliability of water, the equity with which it's distributed, its sustainability and management, cooperative participatory approaches, international cooperation. It's extremely ambitious. Some would say perhaps too ambitious, but arguably an extraordinarily important set of aspirations that we're all working toward, and an outstanding opportunity for us to think about what that world of truly sustainable and equitable water management might look like. That's the good news side. The bad news side is we are not on track to achieve them. And that's the discussion that's going on in New York this week. We are not on track to achieve the SDG on water, SDG 6. And because the SDG is so vitally different from the MDG, it's really not a straight line progression. If we do more of the same, we won't achieve the SDG on water. We really need to be rethinking several of the basic paradigms that we manage water with. We need to, I believe, rethink our economic paradigm for water. We all say and know that water is valuable and scarce, but generally we don't treat it that way. Generally, we don't signal for scarcity for value. We don't focus on economic policies that necessarily optimize the use of water, its allocation, its sustainability, its conservation. We also really need to look again at our water engineering paradigms. Traditionally, 19th century anyway, the focus on water was simply to bring water in to wherever you needed it as cheaply as possible and evacuate it, get the dirty water out as quickly as possible. Didn't focus on the efficiency or productivity of that water. It didn't focus on the sustainability of the water, its allocation or use when there, because there was plenty of water. So that may have been rational, but it's no longer rational. In a finite world, we need a much more circular engineering approach, where we use and reuse water of different qualities and from different sources for different uses. And we need to re-examine our water management and planning paradigms, really our water management paradigms. We need to be much more multi-purpose in our focus. We need to be much more focused on planning that looks multi-purpose and integrated, on management that's flexible and adaptive. We need to have institutions that are inclusive and that deliver equity as well as efficiency. We need infrastructure that is nature-based as well as human-built. And we need information systems to tell us if we're on track, to tell us if we're making progress toward the goals that we choose for our water. So when we're looking at these SDGs this week, and we're looking at SDG 6, it's a good opportunity to step back and realize that we really need to take a fresh look. We have to have these discussions that we're having here this morning to put ourselves on track to meet the ambitious goal of the SDG. But let me step back now to today's topic more specifically. We're talking today about water security in a changing world. So first of all, what do we mean by water security? I think the simplest definition is simply the importance of managing our water to leverage its benefits and productive uses, and to manage and limit its destructive aspects. And if we move out from there, we can think about water security as not just a question of managing scarcity, although managing scarcity really is essential. We need to manage scarcity by being more efficient. We need to allocate it more wisely. We need to look at the range of water sources, and we need to look at non-conventional water sources, like wastewater reuse, rainwater capture, stormwater capture, desalination. But water security goes beyond water scarcity, because water security also looks at the flip side, at the negative aspects of water management. It looks at the need to manage risks, at flood, at drought, at contamination. It looks at the need to manage disruptions to water services, when water might be shut off for mechanical reasons, or for financial reasons, for social reasons, or for disruptions due to fragility, conflict, etc. So water security is much more than simply water scarcity, and it's that much more complicated as a consequence. Some people ask, what's the difference between water security and integrated water resources management? I like to think of integrated water resources management as the process that helps you to plan and manage your water. Water security is essentially your goal. It's the state in which you have secure water available in productive ways and protection from destruction. But the goal is one that is always changing as well. Because as economies develop and opportunities are created, our goals change for water. What we want from the water changes. Surely we have seen that societies as they develop change what they use their water for. More industry, perhaps, rather than agriculture. Much more emphasis on recreational uses, on aesthetic uses, certainly on water quality. So water security is also a dynamic and changing goal. And it manages itself, it needs to be managed at many different levels. We can talk about water security on a broad international basin level, with all of the host of challenges that come from managing a river with shared riparians, and all of the benefits that come from that as well, the flexibility that it might give you to manage coordinated reservoirs and aquifers across a larger space to bank water where you need it, down to within nations, within cities, and across sectors within cities, even within villages. Water security has a different meaning at all those levels and is important at all those levels. And when we go to achieve water security, we look to many different tools. People like to talk about the three or four I's, depending on how you define them. The I's being information, the information to understand, particularly in increasing uncertainty and greater extremes, the availability of water, forecasts of water, etc. The institutions that then respond to that information and do the planning and the management of water, and the infrastructure that is needed, both natural and built, to manage and move and clean and provide the water where you need it. The fourth I, which arguably is under institutions but sometimes deserves its own recognition, is incentives. Whether this is pricing or fines or fees or regulations or tax breaks or credit schemes, the incentives that we create for the way water is used, the way water is managed, is really essential to whether or not it will achieve the gains that we want water to achieve. It's this issue of aligning our aspirations for water with the policies that are directing where that water is made available, because we know that where water is made available, and at what price, and at what time, and in what quality, all of these will determine what opportunities are available. And this has enormous impacts for patterns of growth, structures of economy, equality of opportunity, and frankly, the societies and economies and ecosystems that we all hope to see in the future. So, water security and water security in a dynamic world. The challenge of the dynamism in the world around water security is that we know there are certain basic trends that will not change. We know populations are growing. We know that as populations and economies grow, every individual demands more water. Whether they need that water to achieve what they want is an issue of efficacy and efficiency and productivity. So if we know that water demand is increasing, We know that water pollution is increasing, both in volume and in virulence in many ways. How do we get ahead of all of this? How do we try to manage our water with foresight rather than just waiting for disruptions, waiting for Cape Towns to occur, waiting for water contamination to occur, waiting for water rights to be frozen in place where they don't respond to the needs and the priorities of a society? How can we really move forward more proactively in managing our waters and investing in the information systems, the institutions, the infrastructure to give us the water uses that we want? These are the real questions for us. And these are a lot of the questions that we'll be talking about this morning. From IMI's perspective, we're also in the process of developing our next five-year strategy. So I'm very much looking forward to the discussion this morning and participation from those who are online and even later to help us understand your priorities. We feel at IMI that we need to step back and take a broad look at the water challenge. Traditionally, IMI focused on irrigation water. We now know that with scarcity and complexity and interconnection, you can't look at any one sector in isolation. We must all take a broad look. Doesn't mean that we all need to do everything, but we all need to locate our challenges in the context of an interconnected water system. So at IMI, we're looking into moving into three new spaces, three new broad spaces that we'll be defining most likely as water, food, and ecosystems, water, climate, and resilience, and water growth and transformation. Because we believe that water plays a central role in agriculture and ecosystems. We believe that water is central to climate and resilience, and it's not getting the space it needs in that discussion. Water is to adaptation as carbon is to mitigation. And we believe that it's central to growth and transformation. The economies that we want, the societies that we want, the ecosystems that we want are influenced quite strongly by the way we manage our water. And so we need to manage it mindfully for that. So I'm looking forward to Meredith's presentation, to the panel discussion, and to the discussion with all of you to share your ideas and perspectives on what our priorities should be for water security in a changing world. Thank you.